Welcome, I'm Casey with Inspired Flight. In this video, we'll be discussing the proper takeoff and landing procedures of the IF-800 Tomcat. If you haven't already, please check out our previous video covering the setup and pre-flight check. A reminder, as the pilot in command, you are solely responsible for the safety of the flight and for those around you. Please take the proper precautions to ensure a safe flight. With the ground control station and IF-800 powered up and the pre-flight check complete, let's take off, perform an 8-point check, and then land. I'd recommend standing directly behind the aircraft to reduce disorientation of the flight controls when performing these procedures. The IF-800 is capable of automated or manual takeoff and landing. Automatic takeoff can be achieved with or without a pre-programmed mission. Without a mission loaded, use the Actions menu on the left side of the HearLink to prompt an on-screen slider to confirm an automated takeoff and hover at a default altitude of 10 meters. This will put the aircraft into guided flight mode and will need to be returned to loiter mode or position hold by pressing the A or B buttons to regain pilot control. With the mission loaded, the on-screen slider will be shown automatically. If the slider is closed, it can be reopened using the Actions menu on the left side. When the slider is confirmed, the aircraft will automatically take off, ascending to a specified altitude, then begin its programmed mission. We will cover advanced mission planning in another video. The IF-800 uses default Mode 2 controls, meaning the left stick controls throttle and yaw, or the vehicle's ascent, descent, and heading rotation, and the right stick controls pitch and roll for forward, backwards, and side-to-side movements, all relative to the nose of the aircraft. To manually take off, start the motors by moving the left command stick down, then to the right, and hold until the motors start to spin. Release the command stick back to the center once the motors begin spinning. Now, move the left command stick straight up and the aircraft will lift off. The left command stick controls the ascent and descent of the IF-800. Keep in mind, the more input you provide, the faster the aircraft will ascend or descend. Once in the air, return the left command stick to the center position and the aircraft will hover. Now that the aircraft is hovering, let's perform an 8-point check. With small movements, move the left command stick up, then down to verify the ascent and descent. Then, left and right to check the yaw or rotation of the aircraft. Again, with small movements, using the right command stick, move the stick forward, backward, then left and right to check the lateral movements. To manually land the aircraft, position the vehicle over your landing area and slowly move the left command stick down. Be mindful of how fast the aircraft is descending, as it will not slow itself once it gets lower to the ground. You are in full control of the descent speed. Once the aircraft touches down, move the left command stick to its full down position and hold until the motors stop.
If you descend too quickly and encounter a bounce, re-establish a safe hover and land again using less input on the command stick.
Automated landing can also be initiated by using the Actions menu on the left side of the screen to prompt a slider to confirm the action. If used, the aircraft will land at its current location. A reminder, it will land in place, so clear your landing zone before using this action. The pilot can regain control by pressing the A or B buttons on the controller to change flight modes. Stick mixing is available to make fine adjustments using the right command stick before touching down. You can land the IF-800 automatically by activating the return to launch button indicated by the home icon on the controller. Keep in mind that by default the aircraft will ascend to a set RTL altitude before returning to its launch position. It will orient itself to its takeoff heading, then begin to descend. Once the aircraft has touched down, the motors will power down. Stick mixing is also available to make fine adjustments using the right command stick for more accurate landings. At any point, you can cancel an RTL to take over manual control by pressing the A or B button on the controller to change flight modes. We will cover return to launch settings and flight modes in another video. This covers our takeoff and landing procedures for the IF-800. Join us in our next video as we cover the basic flight modes and controls.